Even Dr. Ghali, his name? Even Dr. Ghali said, he never said Prophet Muhammad, Allah prayed to Prophet Muhammad. He said Allah showered him with his prayer. First of all, Azhar University, I don't take him serious.
That's up to you.
Okay, I make it clear. I don't take him serious.
Yeah, but that's a problem.
Anyone that knows Arabic language, he knows that Salat has different meaning. For this man to say this,
he knows better than his scholar, basically.
So, Salah, Barakah, and Mercy all used in the context. So they're different, they cannot be used as the same because he didn't say my Rahmah is for my Rahmah to precede my Barakah.
Allah sends his
So the Christians
have gone to the bandwagon.
That's
the wrong understanding.
What scholar said? That's what hijab said.
And I asked him,
Mohammed hijab said that. Yeah.
Then he was like,
no, he's incorrect. Allah doesn't pray. Allah doesn't.
He says, pray for blessings.
For me, I could give him a modern day scholar. If he was a classical scholar, so I'm just asking him, like, you know. But that's acting, for me, that's acting up to the camera. You understand? So. Because that's why he criticized me first, so then I was saying he's a hypocrite because he criticizes me saying I act up. So that conversation I purposefully didn't act up, but then he's acting up like showboating for
but
the camera.
But you extended your claim of being disingenuous to the whole of the Dawah team, meaning every Muslim that comes in.
To be honest, if I said that, it's probably not every Muslim. And but it's probably because I was just speaking like a thing, but it was more aimed at him.
What is your aim then?
Is that
Brother Ibrahim?
No, yeah. But the thing is, you can have a discussion or you can have a debate where it's a bit more like.
But what's your intent behind it though?
My intent is just to educate people. But then I find some people, they're not necessarily trying to engage with what you're saying and they're kind of playing.
To the camera.
Exactly. So I would do the same. If it's trapping people on their words.
Are you a Christian?
Yeah.
So don't you I take it you believe Christianity is the right way?
Yes, 100%.
So isn't that what your intent is though, to call the people? Because for me, what happens, I'm not accustomed to coming here.
I listen
to it, but because for me, as a Muslim,
We
obviously believe that Islam is the right way.
Yes.
So our intention is to call the people to the correct Islam. It's not to win a debate.
Yeah.
Because because what happens,
yes.
Because human beings, we have weaknesses within ourselves.
Yeah.
So all of a sudden, you're...
What is it?
So our intention is not to win an argument. It's not to win an argument.
Yeah.
Because for me, if I believe in the hellfire and I believe in paradise, that's what it's about.
Yeah.
So I want, if I'm upon good,
an edifying conversation.
I want you to have that good. It's not to win an argument. It's not to win an argument, do you understand?
But the thing is, sometimes some people are like that. So then that's.
But what are you like? I'm asking you about you.
My first preposition is that the person isn't engaging in the dialogue, so I give them that benefit of the doubt. But I've noticed some people, they're not like that. So then it's like it just becomes into a debate to refute their point, like with an argument.
But as a Christian, what are you calling the people to?
What do you mean, what am I calling it to?
No, because do you not want that good for the people? What is your call?
Yeah, but
it seems like
saying.
You're just talking about debating, having a dialogue.
But that's what I'm saying. A dialogue is explaining the misconceptions about the faith. You understand? So obviously, that's still calling someone to the faith because you're explaining.
Your headphones.
You're explaining misconceptions or whatever. So you're still, if you're having a dialogue, you're still expressing your belief.
But so did
Shams
declare that thing for you when you said that? When you said that about Allah, when you said that about Allah praise,
he asked me. He said which scholar, and then I asked him. Scholar. Then he was like, goo goo goo, ga ga ga, or whatever you said. And then I said, because I said I can bring out Dr.
Yeah, bring
Ghali.
Bring it. He said Salat the only means. Because I want you here to show you that Christian lies here. Okay, I want you to tell me, Dr. Ghala, Taqiyya is a new book. Taqiyya is a new book. Paul said,
Stop lying here, bro.
Okay, this is Dr. Ghali's Quran.
Wait. Listen to my question. My question, Donkey can understand this. Donkey, I'm going to speak to Donkey. My question, does Dr. Ghali says the only meaningful salat?
No, he doesn't give it.
Let me finish my point. Look, I said, don't kick and answer my question. That's it. So my point here is, we already understand Salat, okay. Linguistically speaking, right. Has different meanings.
Okay.
So different.
Wait, finish, bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No,
I understand what you're saying.
Yeah. You know, everyone, if you watch...
One second.
He said... Yeah. Wait, I'm finished my point. If anyone watched my videos with the paper boy, most of the time I'm speaking to him, he's not listening, he's checking his phone. Okay? When I spoke to you about your Christian, not in English language. Why? Because in English language, the son doesn't mean the father of himself. The father doesn't mean the son of himself.
But the Bible's written in Greek.
Hear me out, yeah. So that's what I'm saying. So we should hear me out. Therefore, yeah. we should not trust the English translators because they are translating a text in a wrong way. Because in English language, as English is not my first language, however, I can understand the basic of it. That the father is not the son. The son is not the father of himself. The son can be the father of someone else. But not the father of himself. You understand that, paper boy? So don't tell me we are doing the same thing.
The mother of the book. Who's the mother of the book?
As I said, Dr. Ghali, he is the head of linguistics at Al Azhar University. That's like the
Sunni. Ghali.
He's a Muslim.
No, for who? You have to make a distinction.
He's a Sunni.
No.
So in his Quran.
So that's the question.
Wait. Let me now respond because you were talking.
So what was my question?
So he says. When he puts 3356, he puts in brackets literally shower prayers.
Yeah. Okay.
So this is obviously, he's a linguist. So when I
shower, wait. First of all, Dr. Ghali, he said shower his prayers.
Yes.
In prayers, what does it mean in English language as well?
In prayers.
Does it mean blessings?
Praise is a form of worship, my friend.
Praise
is a form of worship.
Of course, when God bless you,
yeah. Wait, let me speak.
Mean,
let me speak. Because the thing is...
You're wrong to do this.
Well, the thing is, this is why I...
Dr. Ghali doesn't help you.
Can I speak? So, when you asked me which scholar, that's why I said, what do you mean by scholar? Then you started showboating and whatever.
I said, speak a different language.
Yeah, exactly. That's me showboating. So, then, because obviously then I said, Al-Athir, because he obviously goes into
doesn't say that.
But he gives the definitions of Salah and Salawat.
No, but
let me finish. Let me finish and then you respond. Right. Because the thing is, the word Salah predates Islam.
Yeah.
So therefore they talk about the origin, the root of it as well.
Yeah.
It comes from, is it Salah? And it's, which is a form of...
Doesn't predate Islam in
Yes, it does.
Correct. No.
Linguistically, yeah.
Exactly. Thank you.
We talk about Islam in the general sense.
Yeah, but...
He's talking about the Islamic...
Exactly. The word Salat predates, like...
What person came with?
So what people...
Yeah,
before the invent of Islam, if you went to someone, what does Salat mean? They'll tell you it's a form of prayer, dua, whatever. You understand? So that's why in Al-Athay, he talks about the root word and where it originally comes from. The damning point was, since the advent of the Quran, the Muslims didn't take it as that. But I'm saying,
he's completely wrong. He's clueless. Paper boy, you're clearly clueless what's going on in the world.
Okay.
And if you go to Ibn al-Athir, Ibn al-Mandur, all of them say, even linguistically, there's a difference between legislatively definition, linguistically definition. When they say linguistically meaning, predate Islam.
Yes.
Legislatively meaning, of course, Islamic legislation definition. Okay. When you go to Ibn al-Athir and Qurtubi, all the scholars, that even linguistically, there is a different meaning, different roots for it. Qurtubi mentioned there is 8 roots for the word Salat. So it depends on that context again. So not just mercy. So even Dr. Ghali, whose name?
Ghali.
Even Dr. Ghali said, he never said Prophet Muhammad, Allah prayed to Prophet Muhammad. He said Allah shower him with his prayer. In English language, if I say I'm showering you with my prayer, I don't know which one I say I'm praying to you. But understand? So even that, I don't trust it.
But if you shower me, it's still a supplication because you're supplicating for me. You're not giving praise to me.
No, shower with prayer.
Exactly.
Anyway, that's what I'm saying. So Dr. Ghali, for the sake of argument, you know what I did his statement? I put it in the bin. You know why?
He's a Muslim. He's a Muslim scholar. I said he's a Muslim scholar.
No, wait.
Take it up on
first of all, is he still alive?
Yes.
I'm going to contact him.
Contact him.
I will contact him.
He's the head of linguistics at Azhar University.
Because he cannot be the head.
Let me get him.
No, I didn't say he is.
I'll show you.
Allow me to finish my point.
I'm saying.
I didn't say he's not.
I'm saying speak. I'll show you his profile. Yeah, I'm listening.
You know, I watch many videos of yours with many people. You don't let them finish your point.
Yeah, I'm saying speak. No, I'll show you his profile.
But let me finish my point. Okay. Why? Because anyone that knows Arabic language, okay, he knows that salat has different meaning. Okay. For this man to say this,
he knows better than his scholar, basically.
So, look to his honesty. Now, let me have finish. So, what happened to 1,000 scholars? Should we reject them?
But can you understand?
Wait. Paper boy, please.
What's
let
your
me
qualification
deal with you
to reject Dr.
Ghali? I tell you.
But Ibn Athir, a big scholar. What I'm saying to you is
let me.
But can you understand?
Can you debate him? Can you debate him?
I'm saying this.
That's
can
why
you
I'm
understand?
Frustrated. Let me finish my point. Let me finish my point.
Okay, go make your point.
Please, be honest. Because you claim to be honest, correct? He doesn't have a point when he said Shamsi cannot go against Dr. Ghali. But then I'm not taking for my own hand. Okay. I'm using Ibn Athir. I'm using Ibn Abbas. Okay. I'm bringing a big authority against one person. So no, listen to my question. Does your friend has a point against me?
Well, he's appealing to Al Athir. So,
Al Athir. Look at my question. You didn't hear my question.
Yeah, but listen. Yeah, you said, does he have a point? So I'm saying to you.
I'm bringing classical scholars. No, hear me out. I'm bringing classical scholars. If you bring Jewish classical scholars, and then you bring someone who is a modern scholar, going and guess one person, from scholar of the Jewish, going and guess the classical scholars of the Jewish, which one you take?
Okay, now this is the thing.
No, I'm asking a question. Look at my question.
But I'm answering
which
your
one
question.
You take?
I'm answering your question because.
Answer.
The scholar that he's quoting, is he negating that?
That's what I'm saying. He's not negating.
He's not negating. He's just saying this is what it means.
Yeah.
So based upon the little knowledge he has, this is what it means.
Yeah, but this.
But hang on.
It's not little knowledge though, because this guy, Al Azhar University, is like the Cambridge of Islamic University. It's one of the best universities.
Ask him a question. Ask him a question.
You reject the top university.
So, but the thing is, I can appeal to this person.
Ask him a question, paper boy.
Literally, and he's the head of linguistics.
Paper boy, ask him a question.
Yes.
Okay.
What's your question?
First of all, Azhar University, I don't take him serious.
That's up to you.
Okay. I'll make it clear. I don't take him serious.
Yeah, but
that's a problem.
You know what?
Do you accept that's a problem?
Wait. The thing is,
no, paper boy. He has asked my question. No, paper boy.
No.
My question was my question, paper boy. What was my question, paper boy?
He asked me, give me a scholar. I said, which scholar?
No, that was not my question. That was not my question, paper boy. Paper boy, that was not my question. No, wait.
He's a scholar.
Paper boy. Okay, wait.
This is why I asked him for clarification.
Let him speak and we're going
to
go back.
He played up to the camera and was showboating. That's why I asked him. I could have said this name and argued the point, but I said, no, what do you mean by scholar? And then he was doing his language thing, trying to showboat. Then he will say, I'm insincere if I do something. But for me, that's what I call insincere, because then you're showboating for the camera.
You finished now. Yes. Paperboy, my question was clearly, that's why anyone that watched my debate with Paperboy, Paperboy doesn't understand my question clearly. Why? Because he's so busy with looking through the phone. My question to you, name me one scholar said that the meaning of a salat does not mean mercy and blessings, which only means prayers. Why do you write down the questions? Okay, so I said, bring me any scholar said the only meaning for prayer, it is a salat. That's my question. He brought Dr. Ghali. But when I ask him, I'm going to finish my point. When I ask him, now I made it clearer. That Dr. Ghali says the only meaning for salat is a prayer, said no. So therefore you answer a question which I never asked. Is that clear, paper boy?
So Hijab was lying, basically.
So,
Hijab was lying when he said Allah
prays for prayer.
But the thing is,
ask him if he's lying or not.
And then obviously, when
I don't
you
know
go,
what Hijab said to
okay, when you go to Al Athir, so obviously he goes into, he describes the root. I don't have it on me.
Don't lie, Ibn Athir said there's meaning for it. And he said when it comes to Allah, it means what? Showing mercy.
Yeah, so bring up the Al Athir.
Here, Al-Qurtubi caught him. Here.
Okay, because Al Athir talks about the root. Talks about the root of the word, which predates is the inception into the Quran. Yes. So therefore, my argument is this: the word salah was used, and obviously for Muslims, yes, they will say it doesn't linguistically make sense. So they have to then add an interpretation of the meaning to say it means a blessing or mercy, because it doesn't fit with the narrative that God would pray. But then this was a word that was taken from pre-Islam. But even though you have words, because if you went pre-Islam,
again,
there's
lying.
No one that would say.
Show the pre-Islamic days. Salat has many meanings.
Okay, show me the. But he's show me the meaning.
Here, I'll show you.
Not post-Islamic days.
You know pre-Islamic days mean? What they said the root for it?
Okay.
Linguistically,
okay.
The root for it there's eight meaning.
It's salat. Okay.
Jesus call himself?
So not just that.
Because there's, because obviously there's many words, like if you want to use Baraka or Rahma, it's very simple for God who knows every single dialect, every single word.
Allah distinguishes the words from blessings, mercy and prayer.
Allah distinguishes why? Okay, he doesn't differentiate
Allah
between...
Allah himself distinguishes.
I already clarified that to them, but...
They can argue with
No, you can, because why? Know why? Because Allah mentioned the Quran that on the day of Al-Qadr, which is the day of Ramadan, Allah said the angels will descend and the ruh. The ruh is Gabriel. So what Allah said, the angel will descend and Gabriel. In Arabic language, are called when you generalize something and specify it. But we're speaking to someone who cannot even understand English language. He doesn't differentiate between the Son and the Father. I'm looking for it here. No, wallahi, you're an embarrassment, to be honest. Wallahi. Remember, you're the same guy. Remember, you're the same guy who believes that the Father is the Son of himself.
You said, I'm saying.
Give me 2 minutes.
Remember who I'm speaking to. I remember, there's two jobs.
I'm going to wrap this up.
Bora!
I'm looking for it here.
Thank you, Hijab. Thank you, Mohammed Hijab.
Anybody with half an ounce of sincerity will see who's sincerely calling to Allah and who's just trying to block. Who's just trying to hate. It's about time. Yeah.
Intellectual. Honesty.
They don't even know okay. Who said this word.
Yeah, so. So this is from Ibn Aks.
Ibn Asakir.
Have you read? Do you know this hadith?
Ibn Asakir is not.
Yeah, so obviously this is. Yeah, but let me.
No. You said so, Ibn Athir. No, it's Ibn Asakir.
No, I'm giving you it because.
I know the hadith. Allahu barik ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Kala barik ala Ibrahim. Allah Sallam said to send salat and the barakat.
What?
To send salat and the barakat.
What do you mean?
Will Allah say, when we say, oh Allah. No, it's not. Wait, it's not. That's called generalizing.
Yeah.
Please don't embarrass yourself.
What's the hadith?
Let him read the hadith.
Read it, okay.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the hadith where it says, the Israelites said to Moses, does your Lord pray? And Moses said, fear Allah, O son of Israel. Then Allah said, O Musa, what did your people say? Musa said, my Lord, you already know. They said, does your Lord pray? So obviously the Israelites approached Moses to ask whether he prays, not whether he gives barakah or mercy. Then Allah said, tell them, my prayer is for my servants, is that my mercy should precede my anger. If it were not so, I would have destroyed them. So now...
He just moved to you.
You just moved to you. Bro, are you seriously, do you have intellect?
No,
seriously. So the prayer means mercy. So the hadith is plain.
I didn't hear it.
Okay.
No, brother.
What do you want me to say?
You have to tell me what drugs you've been smoking.
Okay.
So again, for the people.
All right. So the hadith starts. It says, the Israelites said to Moses, does your Lord pray? So they ask a specific question, does he pray?
Yeah.
Yes?
Pray,
yes.
Okay. No mercy, pray.
So he said, Musa said, fear Allah. Yeah. Because he said, fear Allah, because obviously he's shocked by the question they've asked him.
Yeah.
So then he says, O sons of Israel. Then Allah says, O Musa, what does your people say? Moses said, O my Lord, you already know. They said, does your Lord pray? Then Allah said, tell them. So obviously the word would be, the root word would be salah. So he said, Allah said, tell them my prayer
is.
My prayer. My prayer.
Is.
What? Can you tell us what the word
prayer
is?
No, carry on.
Because the word, let me continue.
Because
the word here used is salah. Then he says, my prayer is for my servant is that my rahma,
which is not English for the English speakers.
Which is my mercy.
So in this hadith we see the words salah, barakah and mercy all used in the context. So they're different, they cannot be used as the same, because he didn't say my rahmah is for my rahmah to precede my barakah. So therefore this is where we clearly see that there's a distinction in the use of the word. So they're trying to now twist it to say that Allah is saying my blessing is. No, that's not the word was. So they're thinking they've made a point, but they haven't. It's clearly three different words used. Salah, Barakah and Rahmah in all this. And that's why they asked, does your Lord pray? And Moses was even shocked about what they said. So therefore, I don't know what their interpretation is or what point they think they proved. But they haven't proved anything.
Right, Bora, you're there.